welcome to tonight's LCTV production of Littleton High School football. Tonight, your Littleton Tigers take on at 6-0 take on the Maynard Tigers at 5-1. I'm Patrick Fredrickson. Up on the box, driving everything tonight is Mark Corey, our executive director, and out tonight is Mike Fontanella. So out of retirement from Littleton Youth Football, PA announcing is Brian Stormwind. Brian, this looks to be a good one tonight.
No, I'm really looking forward to it, Patrick. We got a matchup of the top teams in the Mid-Watch C division. Littleton ranked number one in the power ratings. Maynard, number three. This should be a battle for the top spot.
All right, so Little just kicked off, and Maynard takes over the ball at the 30-yard line, and first run of the day is up the middle. Pick up about 7 yards, so it's going to be second and three for Maynard. Maynard comes in just a game behind Littleton overall, but in the league, this is a big matchup, as Brian was alluding to. Both teams are undefeated, and there's a little bit of a revenge match here, Brian, from last year, right?
Yeah, that's right. The Maynard Tigers took on Littleton last year and defeated Littleton 20-6 before going on to play in the MIAA Division Finals.
Nice stuff up there. That's Mitch Bowden in the middle there, not letting anybody through there. Excellent tackle by Mitch Bowden. We're going to be, looks like they're going to spot the ball just about the 40-yard line here. No gain on that play, so it's going to be third down and three. If I had to characterize these teams, Brian, I'd say that Maynard is a little bit of a more big play team. If you look at the statistics, they've got a lot of plays over 30, 40, 50 yards. Last week, I think there were three of them over 50 yards.
Yeah, look for a lot of scoring. Look for the scorekeeper to be busy tonight.
That'll be a welcome pleasure after the last few games. All right, Tommy Smith at quarterback. Hands it up the middle. Nice run to the outside. Good tackle out there.
That was Axum Simakula with the outside run there.
So Cole Petone was a big scorer for Maynard. We know Cole from our lacrosse team over at Bromfield where I coach, and he actually broke a foot here, so they're trying to figure out who else is going to score. Junior Tommy Smith at the quarterback. He can throw it. He can run it. Corey Oliver here down the bottom of your screen, 21. He's a serious long-term threat. He's got speed. Corey Oliver in motion. Smith takes a snap. And this is going to be sacked for a loss way in the backfield. That looks like it's Tucker DeCoste in there wrapping him up first. Excellent tackle by Tucker DeCoste wrapping him up and stopping the main momentum here.
Yeah, Tucker stood him up and the rest of the Littleton defensive line piled on.
All right, second and we're going to go about second and 17 here. Maynard backed up to the 45-yard line, going left to right here. Tommy Smith comes in, gets a call from the sideline. Corey Oliver goes to the slot this time. Smith in the shotgun. Motion for Maynard. Snap is back. Smith looks short. He's got a receiver in the flat. He just overthrows him, looking for Sean Premiano. And Brian, you know, you haven't been up in the press box very much, but one of the things Mike Fontanella and I talk about is if you're going to have a chance against Littleton, you got to be able to throw the ball. They're just so strong up in front with that defensive line. Nobody's had a chance at running against them. Running the ball always on first down has not yielded anything this year for opponents.
Yeah, good point. But Tommy Smith is having a great year passing, and I'm sure they're going to try their way with it.
And as always, don't forget to stop by the snack shack.
Ross Cottenham down here on the edge. Brady Hunt sitting next to him on the left side. They go into the shotgun again. Third and 10 from the 45. Motion down to the bottom of the screen. Oliver Smith is going to throw. He rolls out to his left. He's got some room. Brady Hunt in pursuit. He's going to get out of bounds here. Good pursuit by the Tigers to lock that off. Classic Tiger defense there. Bend but don't break. And that's going to bring up a fourth down for the Maynard Tigers. Good pursuit by Mitch Bowden on that one.
Fourth down and nine for Maynard.
All right, 8:08 to go in the game. Fourth down and nine for Maynard. They're going to bring in the punting unit here.
You got to Evan Lyons back to receive the punt.
And it's a low line drive kick here. Lyons is going to let that go, and that's going to get toward the goal line, and Maynard recovers, but did they go in? I believe they did. Whoa. And Littleton escapes there. Ball get all the way down to the goal line, and the player picking up for Maynard slid into the end zone with the ball, which is a touchback. Littleton's going to take over first and 10 from the 20-yard line. 7:58 to go.
Yeah, that was close as momentum carried him into the end zone, and lucky for the Littleton Tigers there. It could have been pinned back.
All right, Littleton's come out. Typically, they come out with Will Squad a quarterback. We'll see who they roll out today. It looks like I see Luke Elliott out there today. It is Luke Elliott, and they're going to come on this hammer look, Brian. So this hammer look is a tough one here. It's a big offensive line, smaller backs, and they hit the line in between. Bradley Clark on that nice carry here. Bradley Clark is one of these runners that likes to run between the tackles, Brian.
Yeah, Bradley Clark, he's hard to find amongst those big tackles and linemen.
Tommy Keenan out there, Wesley Klein, they're big guys, and Bradley Clark just gets down there between them. And what Littleton typically will do is they will pound in between the tackles, and they'll come with that spread look, and then from a slot position, they'll try to run their sweep. All right, Luke Elliott in the hammer again. Handoff up here. Bradley Clark, he's going to get stopped here for nothing.
Yeah, great pursuit on the defensive line, sealing off the end there.
Oh, it's actually, sorry, that wasn't Bradley Clark. That was Kevin Frizzoli, who's back. Kevin's been out for a few weeks with his shoulder separation, so it's good to have him back. Just another weapon to have in that backfield. Clark, Frizzoli, Mitch Bowden in that backfield. So third about seven here for the Tigers. And they're going to throw here. Nice to Mitch Corey. Little out and up, and Mitch is going to get a first down. Great play.
Nice little crossing right by Mitch there. Nice pass.
Great patience. Interestingly enough, and this is what they do, they switch right up. So they bring in Luke Elliott to run the first couple of plays, and now at quarterback is Will Scott, who can throw the ball a little better. Wolves had some good success here throwing a quarterback. They got to go motion. This is where they like to run the sweep. And they do. They try to get to the outside. And there goes Austin Lynn.
Nice run by Austin to get to the outside and turn it upfield. Nice game.
Yeah, this is what we're talking about, Brian. So they'll pound the tackles. They'll pound the tackles, and they'll run the sweep. They love to run Austin Lynn from that slot position, run that sweep play. All right, Ross Cotton to the bottom of the screen. They're going from the shotgun here. Lynn in motion again. They're going to run him to the right. Nope, up the middle.
Wow, Clark straight.
Big yards, Brian.
Clark right up the middle. He's a strong, shifty guy.
This is a tough team to defend, Brian. They have just so many weapons.
They sure do, especially with Kevin Frisoli back in the mix.
All right, Clark in the backfield. We got Will Scott looking for signals from the sideline. They got the play now. They're going to go for the spread look here again. Too wide. It's Cotton to the top. Up the middle again to Clark, and he's not going to get much here. He's going to actually lose a yard or two. Bring up about second and 12.
That was a great tackle. I think that was by Lucas Miranda, 34. He stuffed that play.
All right, sideline play again, same set. Cotton him to the left. It looks like we got Jackson Ellis to the top of the screen. Snap, he's going to roll out, rolling to his left. Tough throw to make here. He's going to set his feet, looking for somebody. Good job by Will Scott to not do anything. Tackle out of bounds here. Probably going to let that go because it was a little bit benign. Hey, you know, we were talking a couple of games ago, Brian, and Will Scott threw that ball a couple of games ago for an interception, and we were talking about how he probably, as he gets older, as the season goes on, that he will be hanging on to that ball, and that was a great decision by him with nothing downfield.
Yeah, it sure was. That was a coverage sack for sure. There was nowhere to go with that ball.
Going to get a free play here. That's it. Throw it up. And he's going for Jackson Ellis. Jackson Ellis makes a catch, but he's out of bounds. Good job by Will Scott to recognize that they get a free play and go for the home run there.
Yeah, I mean, it's hard to tell from up here, but I'm assuming that was a good hard count that drew him offside. Go, go,
All right. Ross caught him down at the bottom of your screen. Jackson Ellis at the top. Austin Lynn in the slot. Jackson Ellis is going to come off the field now. And they're going to move that ball up. Austin Lynn going to the right top slot here, and I would be looking for him to come on this sweep here. Third and eight for Littleton from the 33. 5:15 to go in the game. That's a big front line. Brady Hunt, Tommy Keenan, Wesley Klein, Jake Kivlin at center. They've been doing a great job all year. All right, he takes it from the shotgun. He's going to throw the ball. He's got Bradley Clark wide open, and he's going to get... Yeah, don't see it yet. Yes! Late touchdown call! Bradley Clark, the touchdown machine.
Yeah, he is having one heck of a year. I think that's his eighth touchdown this year.
I got to tell you, that is not a person you want to leave alone. So they just went to the spread. They went out of the shotgun. Will Scott doing a great job of being patient. And again, because he doesn't throw the ball away on the last play, they get another play. Finding Clark coming out of the backfield. Great, great play. And they're going to go for two here. Looks like they are. They're sending Will Scott back in. Going to go with the spread offense. Goalie in the backfield. I'd be looking for him to get the ball here. And they're going to try to push it right up the middle, and they do, and they're in. 8-0 Littleton. Couldn't see who that was, Brian.
That was Bedoin. It was a nice little trap play, and that's their bread and butter on that two-point conversion.
Mitch Bedoin is a big, solid, tough player who is extremely light on his feet. 5:07 to go in the game. Littleton takes the lead, 8-0, and this is kind of what happens every game that we've been. You know, I don't want to jinx him or anything, Brian, but I've been looking forward to a good, tough, competitive game, so we'll see what happens here.
Yeah, I think everybody's been looking for a good game. You have to go back to week one when Littleton won in double overtime against West Boylston.
All right, looks like they're sending out Thomas McGregor to kick off. So Thomas McGregor just started kicking off, taking some of the kickoffs last game, as far as I can tell. He's been sharing the duties a little bit over the last game with Danny Hurley. And clearly, Tommy McGregor did not learn how to kick from his father. All right, McGregor's going to kick off from the 40-yard line. Littleton, 8-0, 5:07 to go in the game here. And he sends it low line drive here. It's going to be picked up by Corey Oliver. Got to stop him. He's got speed. And nice shoestring tackle there. Is that Mikey Corey?
That sure is. Number 10, Mikey. Got him on the shoestrings.
That's a nice tackle, Brian. That's not the last time we're going to be calling 21's number for Maynard. He's an excellent basketball player. He's a big play guy here. And Littleton definitely needs to keep an eye on him.
All right. 42-yard line.
5 minutes exactly to go. Maynard taking over. Tommy Smith at quarterback. Going to come out here with doubles in the backfield. One receiver to the bottom of the screen. Smith is going to hand off in the backfield. Nice pickup there by Maynard.
Semakula with the carry straight up the middle. Got a couple.
I got to tell you, man, calling the game Axum Semakula all game is going to be a good thing for you.
About 5, resulting in
second and 5 for Littleton. For Maynard, 4:35, just passing on the clock at the 47-yard line. Motion to the bottom of the screen. Smith hands off again. Looks like John Sfora there. And he's going to get a first down. Chains are moving.
Initial contact by Evan Lyons. Michael Corey there. Sophomore progress.
Yeah, look for this to be a back-and-forth affair.
First and 10 for the visiting Tigers.
All right, first and 10 from the 45-yard line from Maynard. 4:11 to go in the game. Smith under center. A little tight set here, two in the backfield. Wides are in. Tight end in motion. And it's a handoff up the middle. Going to pick up about 6 or 7 yards here to about the 39-yard line. Nice group tackle by Littleton.
The post
Be second and short. Let's see if Tommy Smith drops back to pass. Pick up a chunk.
But Tucker Coast on that tackle again here. Tucker had a kept having a couple of good games here. And Maynard's just going to keep pounding the ball on the ground. Yeah.
That's Peter Jordan with the carry there. They're really mixing it up.
You know what I like about Pete Jordan here? We haven't seen this against other teams. It's, you know, he really secured the ball as he was getting hit there, got turned around and kept his feet going. It kind of reminded me of Bradley Clark. All right, the chains move again. Smith under center. Two in the backfield. Go with the I formation. And they are just going to keep running the ball. John Sforza again. He gets to the outside. He's going to pick up a first down and more. It's pick up about 16. Maynard just kind of hammering their way right now.
Yeah, Littleton's got to do a better job on the line, shedding their blockers and sealing off the edge.
3:03 to go in the game. 8-0 Littleton. First and 10 for Maynard from the Littleton. Looks to be about the 8-yard line. This should be first and goal. 7-yard line, maybe. And they're just going to keep it on the ground. Trying to get to the outside. Good pursuit by Littleton. Pick up about 2 or 3 there. Should be about the 4-yard line.
Nice tackle there by Mitch Crory, or Mikey Crory.
We're right here on this field. Mikey Crory had a couple of interceptions, a big game, and he's been on the field ever since. All right, so 2nd and 2 from the 2. Made it comes out. They come with a tight set. 2 of the backfield, I formation. Smith under center. Hand off straight up the middle, Sforza, I don't see any arms. I see one hand coming up for the ref, so he's not in.
I think he's short. Nice job by the defensive line, getting low.
Something's telling me this is going to be a 4-down territory for these guys.
Yeah, I don't think we'll be seeing any field goals today.
All right, 3rd and 2 from the 2. No gain there is what I see on the clock.
3rd down and goal.
2 minutes to go. And Maynard's going to send one wide to the right, one in the backfield. Smith under center. Hand off up the middle again. They're going to stay with that play, and he's going to get in. Sforza, touchdown, Maynard.
All right, just like we thought. Might be a lot of scoring in this game. Really a good job by the Maynard Tigers moving the ball down the field.
Yeah, I'm a little surprised. You know, Littleton is very, very tough between the tackles defensively, and that last series, it seemed to me that Maynard kind of had their way.
Yeah, Littleton's going to have to get a little stouter.
All right, 1:48 to go, 8-6. Maynard coming out, and I don't see a place kicker there, so I'm going to say that we are going for a 2-point conversion. I formation, tight set. Smith under center. They're just going to keep the ball on the ground. Nice tackle and penetration there. Saw Brady Hunt in there. Stifle him down, and that could be big as this game comes to an end. I mean, toward the end of the game.
Just a great play there to stop that 2-point conversion.
All right, so 1:48 to go in the game. Littleton up 8-6. Nice stop on the 2-point conversion, as Brian just pointed out. And Brian, you know, as we think toward the playoffs and things like that, I would not be surprised if we end up seeing these two teams play again.
Yeah, I'll tell you, I hope so. I think these guys are clearly a good matchup. They have similar games. And I'm really excited for this game. Like I said, man, you know, going back to the first week where we had that double overtime victory on the road, which should have been a home game, but the field wasn't open at that point. For Littleton to go on the road, get that win, it was nice to see them rack up a lot of points against the last 5 or 6 opponents. But I'm ready for a competitive game, get them sharpened up for the playoffs.
Well said. Peter Jordan back to taking the kickoff for Maynard. It looks like Kevin Frizzoli's back there to take the kickoff, which again is a good sign. It's just one more weapon that Littleton has in their backfield, kick returning. I mean, they literally go 5 guys deep. If you talk about Mitch Bowden, Kevin Frizzoli, Bradley Clark, and then you look at the kids like Leo Gibbons and Dooley, who has been having a great season so far. So we'll see how that goes. All right, Peter Jordan getting set to kickoff here. 40-yard line. He's going to send it along the ground here, and it's going to be picked up by Littleton. Seth Frizzoli's got the ball. Frizzoli might break one. And Kevin Frizzoli returns it to the 40-yard line.
Yeah, that was a touchdown-saving tackle by James Allen, number two.
That's a great pickup by Frizzoli. And again, that's like, you know, you get Bradley Clark back there. You get Kevin Frizzoli back there. I mean, it's just so much to cover. So all of a sudden, you score a touchdown. You lose a little momentum, not getting the two-point conversion. And then all of a sudden, you turn around and you're playing defense from your 39-yard line.
Yeah, just explosive.
All right, Littleton. Spread offense here. Three in the backfield. Shotgun. Hand off to Mitch Bowden up the middle. And Mitch just keeps his feet moving. He's going to pick up about 4 yards here.
You know, you mentioned Robert Dooley. I had the pleasure of watching him play youth football. And, you know, the kid's a freshman. He's an up-and-coming dude who's gonna carry the ball a lot for the Tigers in the next few years. Kid's got some strength and some speed.
All right, Will Scott with the pitch to Frizzoli, trying to get to the outside, and Frizzoli almost gets to the edge. Just gets tackled up. He's gonna pick up a yard or two here. Nice to see him springing a step. He's looking good.
Yeah, really, it's great to see him back.
Yeah. All right. 8:56 to go. 55 seconds to go. Third and five for Littleton. 35-yard line. Almost got a free play there again. He's going to throw the ball. He's under pressure. Gets by one. Gets by another. Gets by a third. He's back to midfield. Just get rid of it. He's out of bounds. Throws it downfield, and I think that is not going to be grounded. Good play by Will Scott to get rid of that ball.
I tell you, that was a tremendous play by Will Scott, number seven. Kind of reminds me of Joe Theismann scrambling around for the Redskins. That escapability, roll out, look for a player downfield. Unfortunately, there was no connection there, but hey, that was good escapability there.
You know, if we had a pedometer on him, he just ran about a quarter of a mile, and he's finding himself snapping the ball from the same spot, right? But good job by Will to escape those players. Maynard comes at you pretty hard. All right, Will's going to be under Scott again.
We're going to go for it, folks.
All right, snap to Will Scott. He's going to come. Watson Lynn on the sweep. He likes to get to the edge. If he gets the corner, he's good. Run out of bounds by Corey Oliver. Good pursuit by Maynard on that play. 26 seconds to go in the first quarter. And that's Lynn, you know, he's not the fastest guy in the first four or five steps. I take Bradley Clark and maybe Kevin Frizzoli over him. But man, when he gets that 10th and 11th step, that kid is gone. So if he can get that edge, it's just one more weapon that Littleton has for this year.
Yeah. But that was a big stop by Maynard to get the ball back here.
Big play there, 26 seconds to go in the quarter. Tommy Smith coming back in. Clock is stopped. 8-6 Littleton, first and 10 from the 31. Maynard comes out with what the equivalent of a hammer look here in tight. Hand off up the middle. Nice game by Maynard there. No, Brian, it doesn't seem, I mean, the Maynard offensive line seems to be doing a pretty good job here. You know, not a lot of penetration, getting, you know, 1 or 2 yards downfield before they get hit. 3 seconds left, 2-1. We're going to end this first quarter. 8-6 Littleton. Second and five when we come back from the Maynard 36-yard line. LCTV, Littleton High School football. right, welcome back. Second quarter, Littleton High School football. Maynard Tigers playing for first place in their league. 11 minutes just kicking off the second quarter here. 8-6 Littleton. Maynard with second and five from the 36-yard line. Tommy Smith under quarterback. He can run. He can throw. Good game. And there's a fumble. Good job by Tommy Smith falling on that ball. And that's going to bring up third and about 11.
Yeah, it's a tough way to start off the set. Littleton will take it, though. That's a sack.
Classic Littleton. They wait for you to make mistakes and then they just pounce. There have been so many games where it's like 14-0 in the second quarter and you go into halftime and all of a sudden it's 28-0 for a couple of bang-bang plays and turnovers.
Yeah, I think the crowd is going to get its money's worth tonight.
What's a ticket go for anyway at this stadium?
$5 for an adult, $3 for a student.
That's a bargain.
It is.
All right, wide set here for Maynard. Tommy Smith from the shotgun. They got two of the slot. He's going to try to roll out. Now he hands to the inside, and great pursuit there. Was that Tommy Keenan? Tommy Keenan flying in there and making that stop before that play can get going.
I think the coaching staff gave the defensive line a talking to, and they're waking up here a little bit.
That is huge. So 10 minutes to go, 8-6 Littleton, 4th and 12 for Maynard. They're going to have to boot this ball away. Looks like Evan Lyons back to receive. Oh, this is a good kick, a nice punt. Evan Lyons is going to let that ball bounce, and that ball is going to take a nice roll for Maynard. And I think somebody's going to talk to Evan about maybe catching that ball next time. That ball's all the way back to the 20-yard line. Nice punt.
I think there's a flag on the field.
It's a 50-yard punt. We don't see that much here. See what's going on. The ref's coming over to talk to Mike Lynn. It's a penalty against Littleton. I didn't see what the call was. Did you catch that, Brian?
I didn't pick up the call. I just saw the flag.
Yeah. This is why we need Mike Fontanella up here, because he knows all the signals. And when he doesn't see them, he'll make them up. So that's what I love about him. All right, Will Scott comes out of quarterback. 9:32 to go, first and 10 from the 20-yard line. Tommy Keenan going both ways now. We got him at right tackle. Motion for Lynn, hand off the clock, and that's going to go nowhere. Good job by Maynard plugging that middle.
Great job by the Maynard defense there to stop a clock at the line.
All right, it's going to bring up second, and I'm going to say it's probably going to be 10, maybe 11. Evan Lyons lines up to the bottom of the screen, so they're swapping in their receivers a little bit here. Like Austin Lynn in the slot, looking for signals from the sideline. They come in from the cards, and Mike Lynn is going to call a timeout here. He wants to get his team settled. 9 minutes to go, 8-6, second and nine for Littleton. So, Brian, let's change it up a little bit. So you've been at all the games and stuff like that. Your thought on the new stadium from a fan perspective? I know it's different up here in the press box with all the food that we have up here and then, you know, getting paid the big bucks. But what was it like when you were down in the stadium?
Well, I'll tell you, first of all, it's a pleasure to be up here. I'm so happy to be up here to get this opportunity to work the game with you and to see it from the press box. This field is beautiful. The town has been waiting for this for a long time. I can't imagine how excited the players are and the coaches are to be playing on a field like this. And look at the turnout. I mean, Littleton's always had a great turnout. This place is sold out, man.
So we're going to just put you in the checkbox column as a fan of the field, right?
Definitely.
All right. All right, so the Littleton comes out from the timeout. Mike Lynn has his team squared away. 9 minutes to go, 8-6 Littleton. Second and nine from the shotgun. Will Scott, he's going to throw. Looking back for Evan Lyons. He looks down the long field. He's got Austin Lynn. He makes a catch.
Wow, what a catch by Austin Lynn. On the way to the ground, reeled it in.
I got to tell you, you know, I'm looking at the stats, and maybe you can dig up some stuff on Austin Lynn, but I think if you look at his rushing stats and you look at his catching, his receiving stats, he's starting to turn into a Gordy Lockbaum. All right, Littleton comes out with a tight backfield. Hand off up the middle. This is where they're going to pound it. Kevin Frizzoli, and good job just tucking in behind his line and getting some extra yards there. I'm an opposing coach. The one guy I'm not going to get loose on a passing play is Austin Lynn. But then again, you know, you still got to run with him even if you know where he's going.
Yeah, you're just talking about Austin. 10 catches, 22.7 yard average, 2 touchdowns.
I saw him bust the big one out in Tingsboro, and again, that was one of those plays where he was moderately fast when he caught the ball, and he got 3 steps, and he was just gone like a rocket. All right, handoff up the middle. Looks like it's Bradley Clark who will break back. Oh, it's Mitch Bowden. Mitch Bowden, good luck. Good luck bringing him down if you're not tackling around his legs.
It was Mitch carrying Corey Oliver.
Great job by that offensive line pushing that through. Thomas McGregor, Tommy Keenan, Jake Kivlin out there.
Yeah, really good.
Wesley Klein.
Boy, it's hard to bring down Mitch when he gets going.
Jack Scaramucci looks like he's out there on the offensive line as well.
Kevin Frisoli with the carry, short gain.
All right, 7:31 to go, 8-6, Littleton. And that's going to bring up about 2nd and 7 for Littleton from the 20-yard line. 4 down territory probably for Littleton, although Danny Hurley can boot the ball if he's healthy. And it's a keeper here for the quarterback, Will Scott. He's right up the middle, and he picked up a nice yard.
That looks like a first down.
All right, so I got Bowden covered, I got Frisoli covered, I got Clark covered, now I got Lynn covered. Oh, now I got to cover Will Scott.
Yeah, it's definitely a tough job for the Maynard Tigers tonight.
1st and 10 from the 12 for Littleton. Bottom of your screen, wide receivers bottom and top. They're going to go right up the middle here, Mitch Bowden again. And Mitch just keeps that pile going. We've been amazed all year, Brian. You haven't been up here, but Mike and I just talk about how he keeps his feet moving, and after contact, he's like 2-3 yards every single time.
Yeah, it's just so hard to bring him down. If you don't hit him low, he's not going down.
All right, so Will Scott behind quarterback. And it looks like we got maybe Mitch Corey down here to the bottom of the screen. I can't really see who's the top of the screen. Ross Cottenham. Going to stay on the ground here, which is a good move.
That's a nice tackle by, I think it was Tommy Smith tackling, bringing Frisoli down.
Yeah, so a lot of these kids I recognize from basketball, Tommy Smith, Corey Oliver, they're a good athlete. Tommy Smith is a good one. He'll get you some plays on offense, too.
Yeah, I mean, Tommy Smith coming into this game, 44 tackles, leading the Maynard Tigers.
And Will Smith's going to roll out right, roll out to his left. He's not going to get much there, but did he get the first down?
Very close to the first down marker.
Let's see what they marked this one at.
They're going to call it 4th and about a yard.
All right, 4th and 1 for Littleton, and they can pick up a first down without getting into the end zone. And they go with a hammer look here, right up the middle. Will Scott's going to keep it. And it looks like they're going to get the first down. There we go. So Littleton's going to get it 1st and 10, or 1st and goal from the 2-yard line. Four plays to get this in, and I'm going to bank on Littleton pounding one of these in, and I'm going to bank that they're not going to throw the ball.
Yeah. Well, hey, going back to that last play, nice keeper, reminiscent of Tom Brady keepers. It's just hard to stop that play when you got a big offensive line like the Littleton Tigers do.
Yeah, you know, in addition to the offensive line, right, I'm looking out there, so you got Mitch Corey now running tight end from the hammer look. Going to pound it right up the middle and keep that line moving, and we got a touchdown in Littleton.
Hey, if it works for the first down, you might as well run it for the touchdown. Another keeper in for the score.
5:27 to go, and Littleton pounds in another one. Go up 14-6 here. Bringing on the 2-point conversion. Will Scott staying out there, so they're going to not go for the extra point here. And it looks like they're going to go for a wide spread here. Quarterback, yeah, I didn't see. I think it was Will Scott.
Quarterback keeper, I think.
I had it in Will Scott.
That was great defense there by Maynard.
Yeah, a little mic problem here on my end here. Sorry about that, but we are back. So Littleton goes through the two-point conversion and gets stopped, which now brings it back to a one-score game, which is interesting, Brian. 5:27 to go. Good defense by Maynard on that play.
Yeah, if this game stays close, those extra points and those conversions, they could turn out to be very important.
Mike Lynn must be relieved to not go in halftime trying to figure out how he's going to get reserved some playing time. I know that sounds a little bit weird, but it has been, you know, the games that I have done have not been very close. I know he wants to get ready for playoff football. He's going to have tougher competition, so being in a game at this point is very, very good for them.
Oh, it sure is. I'm sure they were looking forward to this matchup and looking forward to the challenge, and looks like we're getting it.
All right, McGregor's going to set the kickoff from the 40-yard line. Littleton up 14-6, 5:27 to go in the second quarter. And back for Maynard, I see Corey Oliver. We probably want to keep the ball away from him, 21. See what Thomas does here. He's going to hit it along the ground, a low liner. And it's going to be picked up on the sideline. Nice return of about 10, 11 yards there for Maynard.
Not a bad return by James Allen.
Yeah, a little juke there. That didn't look like it was going to be much of anything. And a good job getting up the sideline. Group pursuit by Littleton. One of the problems with those little line drive pooch kicks, if you pick it up quickly, you're going to get, you know, 5 or 6 yards before you even have to worry about making contact. All right, 5:19 to go. 14-6 Littleton. First and 10 from the 37 for Maynard. Tommy Smith Jr. coming out at quarterback. And they're going to go with the spread offense here. One in the slot to the top of your screen, one wide to the top, two to the bottom here, two in the slot, one in the backfield. Shotgun formation. Looks like Maynard might come out throwing. We'll see here. They are. Going to give it a little different look. He goes deep down the middle of the field. He's got a receiver wide open, 44, and he drops the ball.
Oh, Vincent Chen would love to have that one back. That was a beautiful ball by Tommy Smith and a blown coverage, and thankfully he didn't hold on.
Yeah, you know, one of the things is it was just a little underthrown, and you know, you start looking, you feel the feet coming, and I know he should make that catch, but I gotta tell you, Brian, one thing that I noticed there is Tommy Smith had a lot of time to throw that football. All right, second and 10 from the 37, 5:13 to go. Second quarter. Maynard comes out. I don't know if that's going to discourage them or not, but they know that they can have a little bit of success throwing the ball. Two to the top of the screen, nobody to the bottom, motion to the right. Tommy Smith is going to keep the ball, and he can run the ball. Nice pursuit by Littleton. Oh, a nice little juke back by Tommy Smith to pick up an extra yard or two, and that's going to be about a gain of 5.
Yeah, that really was a good recovery by the Littleton defense after they let Tommy get outside.
See Littleton putting some players in here that don't get a lot of playing time from time to time, but I think they're subbing in, trying to stay fresh here. Matt Coon in the game.
Yeah, I mean, look at the sideline. This team is deep.
Spencer Weldon comes to the bottom of the field. Spencer looks like he got hurt here. Maybe why Matt came into the game. All right, so it is 3rd and 5 from the 42, and I don't think this is 4-down territory for Maynard. 4:27 to go. And they're going to come out in a spread look here. Wides to the bottom of the top of the screen, one in the slot. Tight end in the backfield. Smith takes a snap, and he's just going to run the ball right up the middle, and he's going to get, oh, a nice job of reaching forward and picking up an extra yard or two. He's going to pick up about 4, maybe. And it's going to be right around 4th and 1 here.
Yeah, great effort by Tommy Smith there, and that extra yard or two makes all the difference in the world. It's 4th and, you know, less than 2.
Actually, good spot by the referee there, so it looked like Tommy Smith got a lot further than he did, but a ref got his knee down as he hit his knee and then extended forward, so good job by these refs.
Don't forget to stop by the snatch, yeah?
Littleton games have typically been pretty clean, Brian. We don't see a lot of flags in them either. All right, here we go. So, come out in the hammer look. Smith hands off in the backfield. And nice job getting into the backfield.
Oh, Mikey Corey took him down on the ankles there. Beautiful tackle. Picture book.
Coming in from that hammer position and just getting down low before that play can get going. And Littleton's going to take over. And Brian, this is what we talk about. Seems like a close game, 14-6. And then right before halftime, Littleton does something. So we got 3:30 to go. We'll see if it continues. They get the ball at the 45-yard line, taking over 1st and 10. But it has the same kind of feel Steelers most of the half times.
Yeah, well, that was such a big play by Mikey.
All right, shotgun snap, handoff to Bradley Clark. He gets to the left side, and he's going to pick up about 10 yards here, 9 to 10 yards. Great run. Again, good job by that big offensive line, moving, creating holes, and Clark's not even getting hit till he's 4 or 5 yards down the field.
Really nice job by Tommy McGregor blocking downfield.
All right. Just about 3 minutes to go here, so it's second and two, so Clark picked up 8 yards from the 39-yard line. Quick handoff, there he comes to Austin Lynn, trying to get to the outside, and Maynard doing an excellent job of not letting him get there. That's Austin bread and butter. Good job picking up that extra yard, though, and Austin pummels through and picks up a first down. Move the chains.
Yeah, I was just going to say, it was a great job by the Maynard Tigers sealing off the end, but Austin slithered through a few of those guys and got enough for the first down.
If you're Maynard, you're thinking, man, just don't let him in the end zone before the end of the half, but it kind of feels like there's a lot of time on that clock. Hammer look here. It's going to be Clark up the middle.
Yeah, I mean, if they were to get a touchdown at the end of the half here, that would really put Maynard in a bad position.
All right, so Clark picks up a couple there, and second and 8 from the 32. 2 minutes and 20 seconds to go. Coming out on that tight look here, two wides. Fumbled by Will Scott, and he just gets pummeled.
Wow, he was stood up by Brian Lawton on that play. Of course, he was fumbling the snap and put him in a bad position.
You know, that is a great job, though, by him to stay in there knowing that he's going to get hit like that and just say, my number one concern here is picking up that ball, and I'll take whatever he has to dish out. And then Steelers wheel, he was stuck in the middle with you.
Yeah, great job holding onto the ball there.
All right. Third and 10, we're backed up. He's going to throw the ball. He goes up deep. He's got a receiver, Evan Lyons, down the sideline. He cut the ball.
Evan Lyons with the catch. A lot of contact.
I'm not seeing it. Is he in? He's in. Evan Lyons went up over the receiver to pull that ball in. Great throw by Will Scott.
Wow, there was a lot of contact on that route, and Evan fought it off and fought his way to the ball and reeled it in. Touchdown. Beautiful.
Great job by Evan Lyons here. 20-6 Littleton with 1:30 to go. And that is huge. This is what we're talking about. This is what they do. It's exhausting. If you're another team, it's exhausting. It's exhausting for me and you. We're not even playing. All right. Two wides for Littleton. Drop snap again. Good pick it up. Going to throw it. Looks like maybe Mitch Corey. Mitch Corey catches the ball, shrugs off a couple of defenders, puts the ball in the end zone, and just like that, it is 22-6 in a game that feels fairly even.
Nice little touch pass there by Scott.
1:38 to go in the game, 22-6 Littleton. Evan Lyons making a big catch to put that ball in the end zone, and then Mitch Corey on a nice pattern, slanting out to his right. Will Scott having a fabulous game, and you know, the thing that I like about Will's game so far is there have been a couple of high-pressure situations, rolling out under pressure, nobody to throw it to, fumbles, balls on the ground, and he is just keeping his composure with everything he's doing tonight. All right, 1:38 to go here, 22-6 Littleton. Tommy McGregor getting set to kick off again. Maynard probably reeling a little bit. And if you're Maynard, you just don't want to make another mistake before halftime. McGregor puts it along the ground. It is picked up again by Maynard. A little break here. Good run back to the 40-yard line. Who's that?
That's James Allen with a pretty good return there.
Got to be careful here if you're Maynard. Going for the big ball here and having to come back on you. We saw it actually last week, a two-point conversion picked off by Littleton and run the other way.
Yeah, I think it's really going to depend on this first down here. See what they call and see if they get a chunk. If they get a chunk, they might just get a little aggressive.
All right, first and 10 from the 40, 1:33 to go, 22-6 Littleton. Tommy Smith in the shotgun. 60 yards to go for a score here. He's got a receiver coming. And, oh, it's That's what we're talking about. Looking for Corey Oliver, trying to free him up underneath on a pick play. That ball hung up in the air, and that could have been dangerous.
Yeah, Oliver found him on the inside of a couple of guys, and I think he needed to take the outside line for that pass.
Second and 10 from the 40-yard line for Maynard. 129 to go before we head to halftime. And what has been an exciting game at the very least. Smith from the shotgun. He's going to send three wides out to the left here. Three to the left, one to the top of the screen. Motion now. Smith takes a snap, fakes a handoff in the middle. He's looking to run. He's going to roll to the outside. And he's going to let it go down the field. He's got a receiver down there, and he just overthrows him.
Wow. Really some good coverage there. Mitch Crory had the underneath. I mean, that was going to be a tough pass to drop it in.
Yeah, you know, it's interesting, though. You know, talk about Tommy Smith, and we haven't seen many. It's good to see quarterbacks can throw. We saw Braden Lynn come in and throw. Will Scott can throw the ball. Braden Lynn's got a phenomenal arm. Tommy Smith just put that ball on the run. He just put that ball 36, 37 yards. So as a football fan, it's actually good to see something.
Yeah,
like
you can see how much talent Tommy has.
All right, 120 to go. Third and 10 from the 40-yard line. 22-6 Littleton. We're going to go with two to the bottom of the screen, two to the top of the screen, one in the backfield. Tommy Smith from the shotgun. Littleton playing a little prevent defense. They got a couple of defenders back on the 45-yard line. All right, and they send it in. Good pickup coverage. Tommy Smith's going to run. He's going to throw again. Good coverage by Littleton right there.
Yeah, that was great coverage by Lyons and Lynn, double teaming that. That play, there was little chance to complete that pass.
Tough call here now. So you're 4th and 10 with a minute to go on the clock, and you're back on your 40-yard line. You got to punt this ball away, or you got to take another shot?
I think you got to punt this.
4th and 10 for Maynard.
Hey, look, they're going to punt this. This is why we put you up here. Fontanella would have said, like, run a handoff or something, and you know.
Truth be told, I saw the formation.
Oh, a little low kick here, and I would stop letting those roll. They just keep rolling the wrong way. Back to the 18-yard line. So Littleton's going to take over with a minute to go.
Exactly.
First and 10 from their 18-yard line, up 22-6.
Well, that was an excellent punt, and they really needed it there because with a minute to go, you don't want to give Littleton a chance here with the short field.
Coming up at halftime, we have the Littleton High School cheerleaders, so stay tuned. We're not going to go to our typical halftime break. We are going to get some good video of the Littleton High School cheerleaders. Mark Crory and his crew doing a fabulous job of presenting these games in the new stadium. Cameras from multiple angles. Hand off up the middle here for Littleton.
Mitch
Bowden chugging and churning and picking up eight.
It's just, it takes three guys at least to bring them down. And the thing that I marvel at is that not enough teams go low on him. You can't tackle that guy on the shoulder pads.
Yeah, we actually talked about him a little bit like McCrubery from last year. You know, you got to tackle that kid down low. You can't hit that kid up high from West Boylston. And Mitch isn't quite at that level yet. He may get there, but, you know, you are not going to have any success up high. All right, Littleton runs the ball up the middle, first and 10.
All right, that was a nice tackle by Josh Dornelis.
Counting down the clock here, 25 seconds to go. Kevin Frizzoli on that last carry. First and 10, it's going to be about a second and 10 here from the 28. And I think that we're just going to probably see Mike Lynn run this clock out. And when you go 6-0 against a team that's right on your heels at 5-0, playoff implications, league implications, you're happy to go in the halftime at 22-6. So 4-3, we're at 2 seconds here. We go to halftime. Littleton up 22-6. LCTV, stay tuned now. We are going to go to production and catch some of the Littleton High School cheerleaders coming out.
Ladies and gentlemen, tonight's halftime cheer routine will be performed by the Division 12 Large White Squad. They are coached by Liz Honeshell, Lynette Sundquist, Caitlin White, and Juliana Banda. Let's give them a warm welcome to Alumni Field.
everyone. Littleton High School Football, LCTV. 11 minutes to go, second half. We're just kicking off for the second half here. 22-6 Littleton. Brian, your thoughts on the first half?
Well, my thoughts are Maynard is going to have a tough time getting back into this game if they don't stop the Littleton Tiger offense. And Littleton, you know, after that first drive, Maynard went down the field and scored that touchdown, and Littleton's defense has stiffened up.
Yeah, good point. And, you know, what makes it especially tough here is this is what Littleton manages so well is coming out here. Littleton's going to get the ball to start the second half as well. So, you know, if Maynard doesn't get a stop here, then you're looking at a pretty big deficit to overcome. But anyway, here we go. Second half football, LCTV, Littleton High School. Maynard getting set to kick off. 40-yard line. Bradley Clark back deep for Littleton. Maynard's going to kick here from left to right as we look at the press box. Littleton drops back into coverage formation here. They expected a little bit of a long kick. Austin Lynn drops back. Kevin Frizzoli, a couple of those up men. Mitch Corey up here at the 40-yard line. Luke Elliott, hands guy up here at the 50-yard line. All right, and here we go. Sends it along the ground here. Looks like it's going to be Kevin Frizzoli. He picks up the ball at the 40-yard line, 30-yard line. Tries to run to his left. Back to the 40, 42-yard line. Good run back by Kevin Frizzoli. Picks up about 12 yards from where he picked up the ball. Good start for Littleton.
You know, it's really nice to see Kevin running hard and strong. Doesn't look like any of the effects of the injury are carrying over. He's got confidence and he's running hard.
Yeah, separated shoulder is tough to come back from. That thing is sore. One good pop on that and that can send it back to the sideline. So it's good to see him running like that. All right, Littleton comes out. Two wide receivers to the bottom of the screen. One to the top. Out of the shotgun. Austin Lynn in the sweep. He's going to go right. This is what he likes to run. Cuts it back up nicely and picks up a couple of yards there. Maybe three.
Yeah, pretty good recovery by the Maynard defense there to bring him down.
All right, Will Scott looking for the sideline for signals. Ross Cotton to your bottom of your screen here. Going to line up Austin Lynn in the slot again. Shotgun formation, Austin Lynn in motion again. And they're going to hand it right up the middle to Bradley Clark, and he is just gone.
Wow, the previous play just set that play right up, that inside hand off the clock after the fake to Lynn. That's a beauty.
You ought to call him Matrix, man. He touches the ball, and then he's 7 yards downfield. And I don't really see what happens in between. All right, first and 10 for Littleton from the 44. In motion again, and we're going to hand it right up the middle. Clock again, or going to drive for 5 yards.
Hey, if it works, keep going. Keep feeding them the ball.
All right, clock's coming out. Mitch Bowden comes into the game with Kevin Frizzoli. Austin Lynn comes out as well. So you swap out Austin Lynn and Bradley Clark and bring in Mitch Bowden and Kevin Frizzoli.
Yeah, talk about a switch up. Now you got to face a big guy like Mitch, who's so hard to bring down.
And they give it right to Mitch. He tucks it in, and he's going to get it a big pickup here down on the 25-yard line. Pickup of 15 for Mitch Bowden.
Consistently takes three guys to bring Mitch down. That was just awesome.
9:28 to go in the game. Third quarter, first and 10 for Littleton from the Maynard 25, 22-6. And Littleton looks to be rolling here. Ross Cotton at the bottom of the screen. Full backfield, and Will Scott's just going to keep it and pound it up the middle. Picked up about 7.
Well, that offensive line, led by Jake Kivlin at center, is just moving them back.
Clock has him picking up about 5 yards here, but I think he's got more than that on that last play. We'll call it 2nd and 5. Inside handoff to Mitch Bowden. He's just chugging. He gets the corner, and that's going to be a touchdown, Mitch Bowden. And I'm not really sure he got touched. Mitch Bowden taking it in from just inside the 20-yard line. And Littleton is now going to go up 28-6 with a chance for a two-point conversion. Brian, this is what we talked about. It is like a close game, and then all of a sudden you look up at the scoreboard, and it's like, what happened?
Yeah, it really looks like the Littleton offense is wearing down this Maynard defense. They do not have an answer for the switch-ups here. We go from speed to power, and they have no answer.
All right, Littleton for the two-point conversion. It's going to be a pitch. It's going to be Austin Lynn trying to get in, and he's going to get the pylon, I believe. Yes! Pylon in, he's going to push it to 30. 8:47 to go, and great job by Austin Lynn. He got hit at about the 1 yard line, extended, kept his feet going, and then really had good awareness of where that pylon was. And right in front of the referee, he was able to hit the pylon and get the 2-point conversion.
Yeah, Austin just couldn't be denied there. He had his eyes set on that pylon, and he hit it.
Mike Lynn talking to Tommy McGregor about the kickoff, and I'm sure his instructions are something along the lines of, don't kick this out of bounds. Keep it in play.
Yeah, no unforced errors here, and Littleton is just rolling.
8:47 to go in the third quarter, and Tommy McGregor getting set to kickoff. Kind of a hush has come over the entire crowd here. I think Littleton, maybe the fans were hoping for a little closer game today, just for at least through the third quarter. And the game's not over. There's still a lot of time left here. I get that. But we've seen a lot of scores like 30-6. So we'll see what happens here. See how Maynard responds. Tommy McGregor gets to kick off here. Going right to left, and he puts it along the ground here. And that's going to pick up at the 40-yard line, falling on. That's going to do. Ooh. Nice job by Maynard to fall on that ball.
That was Rex Pinson who covered that ball up.
Brendan Clary coming in to make sure he doesn't get up. First and 10 for Maynard at the 40-yard line, just at the 40-yard line. 8:47 to go, 30-6, and we'll see what Maynard comes out with. And I think if you're the Maynard coach, you want to tell your kids, you're not going to get it all back at once. Let's get one score here and see how we do.
They really need to move the ball here. They need to hold it and move it, and obviously they need to score, but they got to keep the defense off the field.
Smith is going to keep it. He can run the ball. He's looking for a corner, and great job by Ross Cotton to hold that edge. So, you know, Ross Cotton did not get the tackle on that play, but he did a great job of holding that edge and turning Tommy Smith back upfield so other players can come in and make that tackle.
Yeah, so just a great job of pursuit by the Littleton defense, making sure very little gain on that play.
All right, second down and 6 here. So we're thinking no gain. I was thinking the same thing. I thought it was great pursuit, and we look up and picked up 3 or 4 yards there. So we'll call it second and 6 from the 44. Smith takes a snap from the shotgun. He comes out of the option. He gets a pitch to Corey Oliver. Nice tackle in there by Littleton, and that's going to be nothing. Maybe a loss of a yard there.
Evan Lyons is having a heck of a day. Nice tackle there to hold him for no gain.
He had Evan Lyons, his dad, visit us at halftime, and he was pretty happy with the catch that Evan made in the corner. Told us we needed to call Evan's name a little bit more, so we're doing that, but it's not because it's not Evan's making the play. He's making the play, so we'll keep calling him as long as he does. All right, Jackson Dufour goes to the top of the screen. Corey Oliver comes to the bottom of the screen. Tommy Smith in the shotgun. Oliver in motion here. It's about 10 yards deep. Smith is going to keep it. He's going to pitch to Oliver. If he gets the corner, he could go. Stiff arm there, but a nice tackle by Austin Lynn.
Austin hanging tough. Oliver gave him a stiff arm. Austin was going nowhere. He drug him right down to the ground.
Good coaching by Mike Lynn here. So I definitely noticed. So I was thinking, are they going to match up with Oliver? Because he is a breakaway kind of kid. And putting Austin Lynn on him is an excellent matchup. 6:41 to go. 4th and 1 for Maynard. They know they got to go for this one.
Wow, this is one of the biggest plays of the game for Maynard right now. They got
ball on the 49. We're going to get a timeout here. I think Maynard probably wants to talk about this one.
Yeah, that's really smart by the coach there.
Timeout. Was it timeout Maynard, Brian? I didn't actually see who they signaled.
Yeah, timeout Maynard there.
So 6:31 to go, 4th and 1, midfield. You're down 24 points. You got to keep your drive going. Want to make sure you have the right play in here. And I see Jack Scaramucci coming into the game here. They put Big Jack at nose tackle. So Brady Hunt, Jack Scaramucci, Tommy Keenan. On the edges, you got Ross Cottenham. It's like Luke Elliott at the top of the screen. That is a tough front five right there. We'll see what Maynard comes out with. And they're going to come out of the shotgun here. Tommy Smith is going to take the snap. He's going to run left. He finds an edge, and he's going to get the first down to keep the chains moving. He's got more. Going to get down to the 40-yard line. Pickup of 11. Nice run by Tommy Smith.
Yeah, really, really nice run and a great job blocking by that Maynard offensive line.
All right, 6:23, 6:22, 6:21. Clock counting down. First and 10 from the 40. Maynard a little bit of a drive here. They'll need to answer here, I think, to keep this game close. All over to the bottom. Jackson Dufour, the captain, to the top of the screen. Smith is going to throw. He's under pressure. Sidesteps one. Gets around another. Gets rid of the ball, and it's picked off. Ross Cottom stepped into the alley, picked that ball off, and that is a huge play for Littleton and a heartbreaker for Maynard.
Wow, you really got to give Tucker DeCoste a nod for that play. He put the pressure on Tommy. Tommy felt the pressure. Got rid of the ball a little bit too quick. Didn't see Ross.
So I would guess here that you are going to see a heavy, heavy dose of Mitch Bowden. Bradley Clark. All right, you're going to run this clock. Bowden gets the ball right up the middle. He's going to pick up. We'll have to wait till he's done running. We'll pick up about three or four here. We've seen Mike Lynn coach this before, right? This is one of those things. It's a turnover, and we are just going to take the wind out of your sails and make it look like you have no chance in this game. All right, Evan Lyons to the top of the screen. Ross Cotton to the bottom. Will Scott in the quarterback. That big offensive line keeps moving. Mike Lynn letting the clock run down here. Go with that little hammer look with the wides. Not everybody in here, but this ball's going to stay on the ground. It's going to be Will Scott just pushing it up the middle, trying to push that pile. And he is going to get very close to a first down, probably a half a yard short. See where they spot it here, but I think it's going to be third and just shy. No, they're going to move the chains. All right, chains are moving here, 4:57. The clock is counting down. First and 10 for Littleton at the 41-yard line. And you can see them just eating up time off this clock, Brian.
Yeah, that's the name of the game right now. Just run the ball.
All right. Will Scott from the shotgun. Austin Lynn in motion, and it's a fumble. Good job by Will Scott picking that ball up, and he just throws it downfield. Good job by Will.
Wow, what a great play by Scott there to get rid of the ball. First to collect the ball after he dropped the snap and then to get rid of it.
You know, it's no easy task either picking up a receiver so you're not intentionally grounding that ball. So he saw a receiver, but he put the ball out of bounds and said, you know what, we'll just keep rolling here. 4:32 to go, third quarter, second and 10, 41-yard line. Lynn in motion, hand off the clock up the middle, nothing going there. Oh! Except for 5 yards.
He just does not stop moving his feet. And he is hard to find. He's hard to find behind some of them linemen.
Yep. All right, 4:10 to go. Third and 5 for Littleton, 46-yard line. Deep backfield here. Almost got some action there. They're going to throw the ball. Will Scott unloads it down the left sideline. He's got Evan Lyons on the run again. Got behind the defender and made a great catch. And Will Scott put that ball right where he needed it. What a play by Will Scott. Great catch by Evan Lyons.
Will just dropped that in there just perfectly, right in stride to Evan Lyons.
Well, was Evan or was that Mitch Corey?
That was Evan Lyons.
All right. Big Mitch Bowden. Uh-oh, fumble, and this is looking like it might go the other way. 50, 40, 30. He's getting run down by Fazoli and Clark. And he's run out of bounds at the 17-yard line. 21-yard line. Not really sure what happened there, but good pursuit by Frizzoli and Will Scott to get back there and run him out of bounds. That could have been six the other way. And, you know, I know it's a tough play for Littleton, but classic Littleton right here, bending, don't break. So running that ball down, not letting him in the end zone, good pursuit.
Yeah,
looked
that
like a ball bounced out on a handoff. I'm really, really sure.
Yeah, as bad as that play was for Littleton, and almost a disaster. What a hustle play by Frisoli to get back and make that tackle, save the touchdown.
All right, so Maynard's going to take over. It's marked at the 20-yard line, just outside the 20-yard line. First and 10, 3:25 to go. So Maynard has got a little bit of life here. Snap to Smith. He's going to roll out to his right. He's going to keep it. He's going to fade back, go to his left. A lot of pursuit by Littleton. Not a lot of up place to go. Good job by Tommy Smith making something out of nothing.
Yeah, he got out of jail there, and that was an important play for them to get some yards on that first down.
I'll tell you, when he's running back and he cut back to his left, that ball was hanging out.
Yeah, I thought they had him behind the line, but great job.
Second and four from Maynard. They come out with three wide receivers to the top of the screen. Motion left. Hand off up the middle. Yeah, that's going to be a first down for Maynard. Move the chains, I believe. Yep.
Yeah, you can see Maynard's strategy here, and that's keep the ball in the hands of their best player.
All right, first and 10 from the 15, so Maynard could get a first down here if they get inside the 5-yard line. Oh, no, sorry, it's first and goal from the 9. I got the wrong marker here. So first and goal from the 9, and you know this is 4-down territory. I would expect to see Smith or Smith to keep the ball a lot here. Motion left, hand off to Smith. He hands off up the middle. Not much going on there. Good job by the defensive line to stop that one. Maybe a yard.
Yeah, really important for Littleton to get stout here and keep him out of the end zone. It's almost like a two-score swing here if Maynard can get in, because Littleton was right on the doorstep there, basically closing the door on this game.
1:53 to go, second and 7 for Maynard. They send two wide receivers to the top left. Tommy Smith in the shotgun. Hands off up the middle, and nothing going there.
Scaramucci!
The Mooch comes rumbling through from that nose tackle position and says, I'm not thinking you're going anywhere here today. That is big. And the crowd is yelling, Mooch.
That was a big play.
They are not booing, in case people are wondering. They are yelling Mooch, and rightfully so. So it's going to back them up to the 11, third and 11. From the 11, which makes it third and goal. See what Maynard comes out with here. Semaluka in the backfield. Smith is going to throw. He throws you out to the flat. Nice play there to pick up something. That's going to bring it down about fourth and 5.
I think that was Mikey Crory forcing. Forcing, who is that? Sam Primiano out of bounds. Really important play.
So it looks like the ball is spotted just inside the 5-yard line. So fourth and goal from, we'll call it the 5. Play comes in from the sideline. This right here is huge for Littleton football, huge for Maynard football. Tommy Smith from the shotgun.
Yeah.
Wides to the top and the bottom of the screen. Two tight ends to the right. Tommy Smith is going to roll out to his right. He's going to throw back to his left, and it's well covered. Going nowhere. Looks like Bradley Clark on that play, right?
I think it was Luke Elliott.
Luke Elliott on the red. Yep, he's running that Thunder position over on the right side. And great job by him to not bite, to not overcommit. Let that play out to the right. Turn back to the left. Actually, it looks like Luke Elliott is hurt. Trying to pick up the numbers here. Might be Tucker DeCoste down here. Yeah, it looks like Tucker DeCoste got banged up here a little bit. coming off a little. It looks like he hurt one leg or the other here, but he's coming off on his own power.
Yeah, it's really good to see him walking off on his own power. He had that knee injury last year during the season that kept him out. And earlier this year, he did tweak that knee. You can see a wrap on it. And hopefully he's it's not that knee he's favoring, but it looks like it might be. But good to see him walk off the field.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Unable to convert on fourth down. Results in Littleton with a first and 10 from their own 4-yard line.
All right, so Littleton's going to take over first and 10 from their own 4-yard line. And the good news for Littleton is I know you're backed up on your 4-yard line here, but there's only 43 seconds left in the third quarter here. So we're getting toward the fourth quarter. Littleton's coming out with that hammer look. They're not going to let anything happen to this ball. They're going to...
Isn't that so cute?
Referee's getting settled here, talking to the coach on the sideline. They got everybody within about a 7 or 8 yard width here.
Yeah.
Hand off the middle. He's going to try to push that pile, and Bradley Clark again just finds room.
Just follow that big offensive line.
He's been great to watch this year. All right, so 35 seconds here left in the third quarter. We've got another player down here. Maynard player limping off, much like we just saw Tucker to Coast. These two teams are great battle. I think we've only seen one flag here.
Yeah, that's James Allen that they're helping off the field.
All right, so 36 seconds to go. 36 Littleton, first and 10 from their 14-yard line. Good job, Bradley Clark. Move those chains. Give him some breathing room here. And Luke Elliott coming out. See if Luke Elliott's going to run the hammer. So typically, Brian, what they'll do is when they're throwing the ball, it'll be Will Scott for the most part. We saw Braden Lynn come in. But when they're running that hammer, Luke Elliott comes in. Kevin Frizzoli ran that hammer quarterback position last year. Probably why you understand that running back position so well. First and 10, Luke Elliott under center. And it's going to be Bradley Clark again running to the right side. He's going to find room, and he may go! He may go! Oh! Out to the 33-yard line.
I think that was Corey Oliver who saved that touchdown.
It's a 19-yard pickup, and Maynard has got to be getting a little discouraged here.
Just another great job by that Littleton offensive line.
Winding down here, 5 seconds here left in the third quarter. 36 Littleton. All right, so we're going to take a break here. 36 Littleton, end of the third quarter. LCTV production of Littleton High School football. We'll be back with the fourth quarter action here and see if Littleton can keep moving this football and stay in control of this game.
Calls me googly eyes.
You know you're beautiful, right? You know that?
Even you are beautiful. I got bullied for wearing glasses. Share if you're against bullying.
We put it out there, just took off. 3 million people have shared this post. Don't let bullies get you down. I stand with you. My whole family's wearing glasses. I wear glasses and I'm proud.
I even have the army on my team.
All the kind comments brought my child joy. I don't feel thank you is enough.
Thanks.
All right, welcome back, everybody. LCTV production of Littleton High School football. Maynard Tigers visiting Littleton tonight in a game for first place, and it has been mostly Littleton. A game of fields a little bit closer, but it's 30 to 6, starting the fourth quarter here, and Littleton's picking up the ball first and 10 at their own 35-yard line after being pinned back on their 4-yard line. Going with that hammer look again. Luke Elliott under center. Hand off to Bradley Clark, and why not? Another pickup of 7 yards.
I don't know how much excitement we're going to have the rest of this game, but all Littleton has to do is hold on to the ball at this point, really.
Yeah, they'll just run the clock out here. You'll probably see them standing at the line of scrimmage a lot, waiting for the referee to signal that they're in that 10 seconds before the delay of game. Clock running now down to 10:30, 30-6 again. Littleton coming up, walking up the line slowly. You can see they're just kind of winding out the clock. The ref puts his hand up, and Littleton will now go into their set. Mitch Elliott under center. And they're going to hand it up to Mitch Bowden. How much going on there? Good job by Maynard to shut that play down. It's going to bring up a third down. We got a fan out in front of us yelling, "Watch the sweep." So we will see if he is correct, but I'm pretty sure Littleton will not be sweeping this ball.
If he does, I might lose the substitution job, huh?
All right, Luke Elliott looking at the quarterback, looking at the referee. He's got his hand up. He turns and he just spins with the ball. And it's going to be another Littleton first down, I believe, here.
You know, I've been saying, you know, we've been talking about how fast and elusive Clock is, but when he needs to power up, he puts his head down and he moves the defense.
So far, the only way I've seen that you can stop Bradley Clock is make sure that he shows up at the wrong field. All right, 9:15 to go. Littleton just kind of moved the ball down the field in chunks of 6 and 7 yards. First and 10 from the 48. Luke Elliott under center. Ref's got his hand up. They'll go pretty quickly to a play here. And it's a handoff inside to Frizzoli, who cuts to the left edge. And see you later. Goodbye. He's going to go. Oh, no. I was so sure he was going to go.
Yeah, that was Tommy Smith with the touchdown-saving tackle. No, that's what happens. You get a bunch formation, and Frisoli found the outside, and there was nobody there.
Kevin Frisoli just hit over 200 yards on the season, and that is with it being missing quite a few games with the separated shoulders, so good for him. 8:40 to go in the game here. First and 10 from the 18. Littleton comes out. Still Luke Elliott under center. It's a big line. Got Mitch Corey out there at tight end now. Little pitch here. Pick up about 2 or 3 yards.
Yeah, just coming back to Kevin Frisoli, I don't think he can understate how hard it is to come back from an injury like a shoulder like that, and then just he looks like he's running like he was never hurt. He doesn't have any trepidation about putting his head down. Or his shoulder into the defense.
Well said. All right, 8 minutes. We just hit the 8-minute mark here. 30-6, Littleton. They got the ball down at the 15-yard line here. They're walking it out. The ref has his hand up. They're inside 10 seconds. Luke Elliott under center. And we're going to hand it off inside to Frisoli. He's going to try to cut left again. He bounces off a couple tackles, and he looks like he's going to get a first down. Kevin's a hard worker here. I would not be surprised if they try to reward him by getting him in the end zone.
I was just thinking the same thing, Patrick. I'm sure they would love to get him a touchdown, and I'm sure it would make Kevin feel great.
You know, Brian, one of the most impressive drives I've seen in Littleton was having their way with Tingsboro. They came out to get the ball in the second half. And when they finally scored, there were 2 minutes gone in the fourth quarter. So they kept the ball for all of the third quarter, 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. You know, this is what they do. It's really tough to get the ball back from them when they're running like this. And that looks like Luke Elliott just keeping it, punching it forward.
Yeah, Maynard's chance was lost when they didn't convert that turnover for a touchdown.
You know, I like this, what Mike Lynn's doing here, and you know, I may be totally misinterpreting what I'm seeing here, but Mike Lynn is having his quarterback just move the ball forward, keep the clock running, no reason to run up the score here, there's no reason to try to pump one in, you know, so it's like, you know, good sportsmanship, but it's also managing the clock here, running the clock down.
Right, and protecting the ball.
Now I punch one in here, turn this ball over. Maybe we'll get to see some of the other guys get some playing time here, which is always good for everybody. Luke Elliott under center. He takes it. He just kind of keeps it. I think he kept it. Oh, looks like the ball's on the ground again. Nope. Refs are waving it down. Trying to see who that was. And
Recovered by Maynard.
It was a fumble. It was recovered by Maynard, Brian. All right, so 6:14 to go. 36 Littleton. Maynard got a little bit of life here. But they're going to have to score and score quickly.
Yeah, they've got a long field right now. 6 minutes left.
So going forward, Brian, you know, you're thinking, okay, well, Maynard was the big game that we were looking forward to, right? I don't know how close the West Boylston game was. I saw West Boylston throwing a clunker or two along the way. Is there, you know, what's your thoughts on going forward, Littleton's chances of moving on in the playoffs?
Well, clearly, they're going to be a tough team to beat.
All right, handoff up the middle, breaks a tackle or two, and brought down. Great run.
Mikey Crory with that touchdown saving tackle there.
First down for Maynard.
That is a big pickup for pushing the ball out to the 21-yard line there. Pickup of about 16.
Yeah, I think Littleton defense, they don't want to give up any more points here. I know that the game's not really in jeopardy, but I think they'd like to leave here feeling good about themselves.
Nice stop by Littleton there, no gain. Run up the middle here, 5:38, clock ticking away.
No gain on the play. Matt Kuna checks in on defense.
Mooch comes off the field, Matt Kuna goes into the game. Great job by Mooch, big stops in there, especially down when they were down inside their 10-yard line, pushing back outside the 10-yard line when Maynard was knocking and still had a little bit of life left. I would say I keep very close eyes here on the bottom of your screen here, Brian, at 21. He's got single coverage with Corey Oliver here, and he will take a crack at this before we go home today. Hand off the middle, and again, good penetration in there.
Oh, Mitch Bowden. He was not going to be denied in the backfield.
So Bowden was playing linebacker a lot, I don't know, you know, this year. Last year he was an offensive or defensive lineman. I mean, you know, you got a kid that big that can now move as your running back, run as your linebacker. It is a huge weapon to have. 4:30 to go in the game. And the scoreboard clock went down. I lost track, but I believe it's third down here. Third and 10, third and 11.
Third down and 15.
Third and 15, I just heard the PA announcer, so thank you for that. And they're going to take a crack down here one of these times. And here it comes. Got a receiver down the right side. Good coverage by Littleton. Great job by the safety there, staying back. No place to put that ball. So,
yeah, going back to that West Boylston game, I mean, what a game that was. And, you know, little did we know at that point that there wasn't going to be many competitive games after that.
Well, it's interesting, too, like a lot of those teams that we were typically playing, the West Boylston, some of those other teams, they actually petitioned to drop down a league in the division playoffs. So as you look, you'll see, I think you were looking at the power rankings today, but Littleton's in that Division 6 power rankings, but West Boylston dropped down to the Division 7 power rankings, so I don't think you're going to find them in there. I don't know if Maynard is in there, actually, but there were a couple other teams that are typically teams that give us, you know, competition, and they dropped down. So I'm looking at the rest of the season here, and, you know, if Mike Lynn keeps rolling the way he is, it'll bode well for Littleton when they come back playoff time.
Yeah, some good points there.
All right, 3:51 to go, 30-6 Littleton. Littleton's going to take the ball over at the 32-yard line.
I'm awesome.
Clock not running here. Come under center here, no reason to hold this one up. Luke Elliott's going to hand this ball off to Clock. Clock's just going to keep rolling. And Clock takes the ball all the way to the 48-yard line, other side of the field.
I think it took the whole defensive backfield to corral Clock on that play.
I'd love to see what that kid's metabolism looks like, because he is just churning at a higher level than most people I know. All right, here we go. Littleton, 3:24 to go, 36. Come walking out here looking for the referee. Ref looks at his watch, waiting for that countdown. Luke Elliott checking in. The ref looks up. He's got his hand up. Quick hand off to Mitch Bowden up the middle. And that's going to be gain about three or four. Just hit the 3-minute mark here, 30-6.
One more first down, and that should do it.
Second down and eight.
Second and eight, Littleton. All right, they came walking out. Same thing we've been talking about here for the last five or six plays, waiting for the ref to put his hand up. Oh, they're going to right to a snap here. And
yeah, it looked like illegal procedure by the offense there.
Yeah, it looked like
Littleton.
Half of them were waiting for that call from the referee to put his hand up. The other half decided we're just going to play and get rolling here on a Friday night. So 2:32 to go. Littleton's going to back out. Mike Lynn doesn't want to see that. But
all right, they get the clock started again.
Keeping the starters in here for these last couple of plays. Jake Kevlin leads out that big offensive line. Hammer formation here again. See if they take a knee here at some point. Might be a little too early. They're going to get a free play here.
Yeah, I think it was a little encroachment on the defense there.
You got to like the Maynard kids play until the end. And that's going to back up Maynard 5 yards, I believe. Bring up
looks like second and eight.
7 or 8 for the first down. Well, Brian, before we go, man, 2 minutes to go here. Just hit the 2-minute mark, fourth quarter. Luke Elliott coming out. And on behalf of LCTV, I just want to thank you for coming out and filling in for Mike Fontanella. I hope you had some fun here tonight.
Oh, man, are you kidding me? My pleasure. Awesome time here, and a pleasure to be here.
Elliott under center. He's going to take a quick snap. And that is Bradley Clark again. He is just moving and chucking and jiving. Probably wanted to stay in bounds there, but nonetheless, going to move the chains.
Yeah, they still got the clock running, and they really, I think, we're looking at a knee or two here, and that'll wrap it up.
I think they actually keep running the clock at this level, depending on the score of the game and the time. So we've had the same thing happen in a couple of other games. 1:16 to go, and they're going to take their victory here. Victory knee. Quick shout out to Mark Corey and his cameraman for a great job. I know that they're covering it from at least two or three different angles. Mark is always directing this and managing a camera at the same time. And I've seen some of the productions, and aside from the guys announcing, the productions have been excellent. So if you can ever improve on that, I think he'll be in good shape. Mark, great job. All right, Littleton's going to take a victory knee here. 48 seconds to go. Watch this wind down. Great crowd here tonight. Kind of silenced by the lack of a good game here late in the game. But I think for the most part, Littleton is happy, and Maynard's going to go home trying to figure out what to do next. I did see some good things from Maynard where they can move the ball. But again, against this Littleton team, you cannot make mistakes. They will turn it around quickly, and they'll turn it around at a point where it just exhausts you right before the half, right where you think you're moving the ball. 12 seconds, 10 seconds now. All right, on behalf of LCTV, we will see you again soon. We're winding down here. 4-3-2-1. 30-6 Littleton against Maynard. That should wrap up first place for Littleton, and that should solidify them if things go well in the power rankings going into the playoffs. Mike Lynn has his team exactly where they want to go and exactly where they want to be going into the playoffs. On behalf of LCTV, I want to say thank you. Thanks again to Mark Corey up there, Brian Stormman, for joining us today. And we will see you at the next production next Friday night. LCTV will bring you back Littleton High School football.
Take care, everyone.